Hello, fellow weirdos. Welcome back to some Lost Puzzle with me. And I intend to continue my dark climbing adventure in the Rostock factory. I hope we don't run into anyone or anything. Like, right now, technically we shouldn't, because I know that I haven't triggered certain events yet, so... like that. Could be because of the rain, could be because of camp info, I don't know. Ta-da. Duty and not the scientists, but like I can't babysit them all the time, so I guess what happens happens. Remember what the deal was with the military, because this is a patrol zone, they will want you to stick to the road, so after you have triggered the stick to the road message, which can happen if you get too close to their camp, even from this side, then they will turn hostile. Something to watch out for. Oops. Oh, now that looks like the midlife crisis skeleton. Pants on the head. Oh, it all looks so quiet. So this texture looks like not real. we can stop bleeding on our own. Oh, okay. Oh, recumbrance. Yeah, let's get rid of these, maybe. Let's get rid of one of these. Area. I think I can get across from right here. And of course, when you're coming from the scientist camp, then you can just drop into this. Yeah, it's not as closed off as it looks at first sight. That corner, because I think that one will trigger the military proximity. Yeah, I will take that extra food with me, thank you very much. And now that I have some goodies with me, okay, I have also a day's worth of water. I think I'm gonna treat me with a tour. But first, let's harass some skeletons. Excavator. When the random... Oh! Ooh. That was a bad fall, I guess. Sometimes when the random messages come in, the game sort of freezes for a moment. Like it does before blowout notice, or before the switch distance. Whoa! Dude. That's a bad headache right there. it cost me 3. Okay, disregard everything I've said so far. It appears I already do have a military problem, so I might as well go where I like. A lot of ammo. Wonderful painting. Screenshot. To embark on a little climbing expedition for my own amusement. Somewhere around here is a whole pile of red barrels. A ton of fun to blow up. I'm not gonna do that right now. Okay, so just as I was about to embrace all the somber weather and adjust my activities accordingly, the sun is coming up. Of course it is. Sunlight ruins it somewhat, but still. Wait, was there a gap between these buildings? Oh, oops. Okay, it's manageable. Never mind. viewers might already guess where this is going. Impact. Stuff the medicine in the pants preemptively. Yes. Did this letter work? I think it did. It might. Quick save because we might be getting close to level 0. Oh, okay, it doesn't. This is only for looks. It's like those. It's like painted on. Ta-da! And just like that, we are in the Twilight Zone. So the Rostock Factory Twilight Zone is one of the easiest to get into. Here. At this end I'm keeping the HUD on because there is the underground, the lab entrance level changer, and I don't want to get too close to it. Now, I have not yet fully decided if I want to try to also do this lab out of real game sequence and bypass the whole duty quest stuff, or more like I think it's done with proper failsafes, so it's like if you go in there and do the doodads, then it's like yeah, okay, and it just completes. Since at the moment I'm kind of interested in continuing the game and being able to continue the game, I might not want to mess with the sequences as much as I did as I was during the testing, so I don't know. I'm thinking about it. Now, let's just chill. Oh, I might not be able to cross this path here. I don't remember. Water truck that we do not trust. Some wonderful broken reality. Do not step in there. Pretty well fleshed out in this Twilight Zone. But I guess that's because it's a pretty big map and you will be able to view stuff from many different angles. Okay, this is still solid ground. See? guess some of these it's closer to the inner perimeter. If you're walking around there, you could almost mistake it for a regular map area. Let's have a meal, shall we? This is where we do not want to step. Typical Twilight Zone tree. Right now I should not be able to move the board yet, but maybe I am, I don't know. So, just in case. Like this whole dimension of its own. So this is where it gets very similar to regular map. As if you're just in a backyard or something. That's the thing with Twilight Zone, is that certain objects are two-dimensional. So you might be able to observe their shadow, but not the object itself. Now we're getting closer to the camp. If I see a bandit, I will shoot them. Being in the Twilight Zone just means that you're across the fence. Right there. And yet elsewhere. Still a little chick. Oh! My dudes are still alive. That's good. This little nook here is wonderful around the time of sunset and sunrise. Okay, now I have to watch out for the other level changer. Clear. This is the road, obviously. Disappearing water when you're under it. I don't think that's specific to Twilight Zone. I think that's just how water works everywhere. Like as soon as you're below the surface, there's nothing to see. Really lovely area. So we've got this bit of railroad here. It's like fully fleshed out. And then this little pier here. That might very well be a part of an actual map. glass bricks. Oh, those glass bricks. The Bar Twilight Zone sports a lot of like 70s style research buildings and office buildings, which hit straight into nostalgia for me. Right, and now that I have completed this little tour, I will diddle-daddle around a little bit more on my own, and then I will try something out which might or might not remain as a part of this playthrough, and then it's time to pop back into the map. But for now, I will stop. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you then. Bye!